doing a concert with a lot of variety tonight. We're playing three more traditional concert tunes, then we're going to be playing five pet band tunes that we haven't been able to perform at our athletic events, and then we're going to do a couple of school songs. So there's a lot of variety, but there's something for everyone. And we're going to start off with a piece called Red Rock Mountain by Rossano Galante. And I'm going to read the program notes for you just so that you have a little bit of an idea of what the composer was going for. This composition is an episodic work that paints a musical portrait of Red Rock Mountain, a beautiful mountain landscape in Pennsylvania. It's about 5.5 hour drive from here. Brass fanfares and soaring wind lines begin the piece. It transitions into an emotional section which depicts the mountains at dusk, which makes me think of our very own West Virginia mountains. As the sun rises and sheds light on its peaks, the music becomes lyrical and rhythmically incisive. The piece culminates in a heroic brass finale depicting the grandeur of these stunning East Coast mountains. We hope you enjoy Red Rock Mountain. Thank you.
play tonight. Our next piece is one of my favorite pieces of music of all time. And both of these next two pieces are actually transcriptions, which means they were not originally written for concert band. This first transcription was originally written as a requiem by Brahms. Now, Brahms was one of the grandfathers of the Romantic era. And there were so many innovations musically in the Romantic era, but Brahms preferred to do one thing that was a little bit old-fashioned. He loved old forms. He loved to use forms from the classical era. And a requiem is one of those forms. A requiem is a mass for someone who has just passed away. He wrote this after his mother passed away in 1865, and also Schumann, a friend of his, passed away the same year. So this may have been inspired by those deaths, but regardless, I find this piece to be perhaps the most beautiful piece I've ever heard when it's played by orchestra and has a full choir. And Barbara Bulman has done a wonderful job transcribing the first movement of this Requiem Mass, and we're going to play it for you now. Oh, I gotta tell you, I'm really proud of this group of young people. This has been a year unlike any, and it has been not easy for any of us. And we feel very fortunate that we are still playing, and we're still meeting as a group at school, and have still a full ensemble, and are able to play wonderful music, because we are absolutely in a very small minority of people that can say that. Like I said, it doesn't mean that it's been easy. We've had a lot of rehearsals that we've had to miss because of either weather or quarantine issues. We've had people not be able to come to school for weeks at a time because they are self-quarantining. We have a room of very healthy people, which we are thankful for. And not everybody's here today. And that's just our reality, and we're okay with it. We've learned to push forward and enjoy what we're doing. And if a performance that is planned isn't going to be as perfect because we've missed some people, well, we're just going to go ahead and do it anyway, because that's the only choice that we have. And to listen to the group play the way that they're playing tonight, it's a great feeling to know that they can pull this off with all that gets thrown at us and all that gets thrown at everyone else out there. Our next piece is our last concert piece of the evening, and it is also a transcription of Slavonic Folk Dance Number 8 by Antonin Dvorak. So, for the next part of our program, we're going to be playing five of our newest pep band tunes. Now, we have a large library of pep band tunes that we like to rotate and have a nice thick book so we can play lots of different things during a game, but unfortunately, we haven't been able to play any of these at our games yet. We're hoping we will be soon, but in the meantime, we thought we would play for you the five new ones that we learned. So with each one of these five new tunes, one of our music majors is going to come up and tell you a little bit about the piece.
Bad Guy, written by Billy O'Connell, or better known as Billie Eilish, and her brother Phineas, debuted in 2019 as part of her award-winning album, When We Fall Asleep, Where Do We Go? It is currently her most played song. The song has won numerous awards, including Best Song at the 2019 Grammys, as well as Record of the Year, making Billie Eilish the youngest artist ever to win at 18. The song also won Song of the Year by over 30 other major music magazines. Eilish wrote the song as commentary about how we present ourselves, particularly as the bad guy. In the song, she asks why we feel that we need to present ourselves in a certain way. She then goes to say that she is not immune to the feeling and presents herself as the bad guy too. The song was arranged for Band by Jay Dawson and Jim Reed.
To date, Robert Randolph and the Family Band have been Grammy nominated four times. In 2003, Randolph was placed as number 97 on the Rolling Stones list of greatest guitarists of all time. Randolph's use of the steel guitar attracted the interest of many renowned musicians, most notably Eric Clapton, with whom the Family Band toured alongside as a supporting act in 2004. Clapton would also later record with the Family Band on their Colorblind album. Their song Ain't Nothing Wrong With That reached its height at the number 21 spot on the Billboard Top 100 list in 2007, and its message remains the same. No matter where you are or who you are, when the music gets down in your soul, it makes you want to lose control. Please enjoy Ain't Nothing Wrong With That by Robert Randolph and the Family Band, arranged by Tom Wallace. Single Born This Way in 2010 while on tour in the UK. She wanted to write a This Is Who I Am anthem that isn't poetic or metaphorical, but rather straightforward and to the point. This song immediately climbed the charts upon release in 2011 and became one of the top anthems for minority groups, especially the LGBT community. Along with making the song personal to her, she advises the rejected and outcasts to not allow society to force them to change who they are, because everyone is born the way they are meant to be. The chorus of the song was performed for the first time in 2010 at the MTV Video Music Awards, and later on Saturday Night Live, New Year's Rockin' Eve, Good Morning America, and the Super Bowl 51 halftime show. Rejoice and love yourself today, and enjoy Lady Gaga's Born This Way, arranged by Jane Dawson and Jim Reed.
Thank you. Barr's Blues release in 1964 was a rework of James Brown's earlier song, I Found You, which was actually recorded in 1962 by Yvonne Fair, one of Brown's backup singers. The new version had nearly identical lyrics, but a different beat. In 1965, the song rose to number 3 on the Billboard Top 100, became Brown's signature tune and gave him his famous catchphrase, I Feel Good. It would be performed in a variety of movies and TV shows, such as Good Morning Vietnam, Transformers, The Simpsons, My Beauty Vice, Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, and many commercials. While listening to the song, it is hard not to feel good. The song is a celebration of how love leads to happiness, which brings such joy that you just have to sing about it. The music features a saxophone solo by Marcio Parker, and the lyrics have Brown rejoicing in how good he feels now that he has the one he loves. This arrangement was written by Tom Wallace and Tony McCullough. We hope you enjoy James Brown's I Got You.
Lady Gaga's Poker Face was released on September 26th of 2008 and was an immediate hit. It topped the charts of over 20 different countries and was the best-selling single of 2009, with 14 copies sold worldwide. This song also won Lady Gaga her first Grammy Award for Best Dance Recording at the 52nd Grammy Awards Ceremony, while it was nominated for Song of the Year and Record of the Year as well. Lady Gaga is known for the personal meaning behind each of her songs, and this one is no exception. This song is a tribute to Lady Gaga's rock and roll boyfriends who enjoyed gambling. She stated in an interview that she wanted to create a record that her boyfriends would love, and this song was the perfect solution. The song is about the singer playing with men as if she were a poker player, hence the title of the song, Poker Face. Another interesting fact about this song is that it was written in just 1 hour. When listening to this song, it isn't hard to tell why it became so popular, because it's hard not to tap your foot and sing along, which we encourage you to do, by the way. Our arrangement of this song was written by Tom Wallace with percussion by Tony McCutcheon, and without any further ado, we hope you enjoy Lady Gaga's Poker Face. Thank you.
Thank you very much for taking time to join us tonight, and appreciate the wonderful talent and hard work of these young men and women. We will be finishing up this evening by playing our school's alma mater and our fight song. And once again, thank you very much. Stay healthy, and safe.